Nebraska and Minnesota from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska, here on BTN alongside Matt Millen. I'm Kevin Kugler. Lisa Byington, the third member of our crew, is standing by with Husker head coach Mike Riley.
Yeah, Kevin, thank you very much. Well, you get Tommy Armstrong back, and he will start. But after going through a week of the concussion protocol, how cautious, how careful do you have to be with him tonight?
Well, I think that everybody will keep an eye on Tommy for sure. And he went through all the stuff that he's supposed to go through. And we're like very conservative, which is the right way. He's been deemed okay to play, so we don't anticipate any problems. Well, we'll keep an eye on it.
You have to rebound from that game against Ohio State. Your team had to hit the restart button this week. How ready are they now?
I think this team will rebound well. I think we'll come out and play hard tonight. We're going to have to play well, too, because this is a good team. This Minnesota team has gotten better and better all year long. So we're going to have to play well, and we're going to have to just be mentally tough. I mean, that'll be the big deal.
Thank you.
Mike Riley and the Huskers. Tracy Clays on the other sideline, second-year coach who's won four straight Big Ten games, first time since 2013. In Minnesota, they're not into this defer game, Matt Millen. They win the toss, and they want the football. They're getting that offense on the field right away tonight.
Well, he wants to see exactly how they're going to get lined up against and how he's going to be able to crack. Because this Minnesota football team, they've got to run the football to be successful. They've got two talented runners. They need both Rodney Smith and Shannon Brooks here tonight, but Leidner will be the key to this offense.
Nebraska ready to kick this one off. Rodney Smith and Keontae Harden, the D-backs, the shoes in the air here in Lincoln. They only do that for kickoffs, Matt.
I'm thinking, what the heck are they taking their shoes off for?
Here you go, Nebraska!
What a great night and atmosphere aplenty here in Lincoln. Keontae Harden going to take a knee, and we'll get the touchback to the 25-yard line. Let's check out our Auto Owners Insurance impact players for this one, Matt.
Well, Rodney Smith and Shannon Brooks are two guys. They're the motor that makes this offense run. Leidner's the key, but these guys have to do everything. Nathan Gary, he's a very good tackle. You'll see him down in the box a lot. He's going to be one of the keys to stopping those runners.
And you mentioned the key is that young man, Mitch Leidner, the senior out of Lakeville, Minnesota, but no passing touchdowns since October 1st at Penn State, and in that span, they've gone 4-0.
He's just got to be consistent. If he has a good, consistent night, that'll bode well for this Gopher offense.
Off play action, right into the air on first down, and a good tackle made by Aaron Williams at the 30-yard line after the catch from Drew Wolitarski. Should mention a note at the offensive line on the right side at right guard. Garrison Wright gets the start tonight for Vincent Calhoun. Both of those guys have gone back and forth there. Calhoun's made six starts at right guard. Wright has started all over this offensive line this year. On second down, here's Smith. And Smith bouncing off a couple tackles, but Nebraska driving him out of bounds.
Yeah, you really see this secondary coming downhill fast. This is going to be an aggressive secondary, particularly those safeties coming down. Sets up this third down. The play action will be big in tonight's game.
Wolitarski, the motion man on third down. Leidner finds Wolitarski, first down and out of bounds, shoved out by Chris Jones at the 42.
Kevin, these are very similar teams. Wolitarski and Jordan Westerkamp are kind of the same guy. They're chain movers, they're reliable, they know how to get open. And so they basically run where you're not. So they came out in the formation. Wolitarski just got to the outside, simple pitch and catch.
Wolitarski again on first down, upended near midfield, but a pickup of 8 on first down. Williams and Williams, Kyron and Aaron combining on the stop.
Yeah, and if you're going to give him space, he's going to take the space. It's just that simple. This team is not going to beat you by throwing deep balls and loosening up and all that stuff. It's working the underneath, and exactly how they do it. Wolitarski's a guy who'll just take the space you give him.
Second down and 2. Motion across from Carter. Leidner, good play fake. Lots of time. Looking deep over the middle. He's got a man there, but he could not find Rashad Still. He had a step.
He did, Kev. That's one. Look, when you do take a shot, you got to make them pay. And he had Still wide open. He got on top of the coverage right here. His eyes, you can see the guys. Kalu's eyes are in the backfield. It can't be that. You got to keep the eyes on the receiver. He gets run by, and he lives for another day.
Wolitarski is in the slot to the top of the screen on 3rd and 2. And the give up the middle to Rodney Smith, and it looks like he's short of the first down.
It depends on which one of these officials are looking at.
The one that came in from the bottom of your screen had a little more positive Minnesota spot than the guy from the top half. And it is 4th down either way.
Yeah, see, there's not a lot of movement up front. Banderas does a really nice job of filling quickly. And that's the difference in the play.
And Minnesota opts to play the field position game, and they send the punt team on 4th down and 1. Ryan Santoso, you see 20 punts inside the 20-yard line. Demore Pearsonell, 2nd in the conference in punt return average this year, almost 10 per return. And now a flag down.
That's against the defense. That's a 1st down.
There may be 12 men on the field, Matt, for Nebraska.
That's not good.
Legal formation. Defense. 12 players in formation. 5-yard penalty will result in a 1st down.
Boy, a critical error by Nebraska on special teams. 12 men on the field, and you give Minnesota the first.
Yeah, and Mike Riley is being calm. I would know a lot of other coaches who'd be losing their minds right now with their special teams coach. That's inexcusable.
Bruce Reed is the special teams coach for Nebraska. Mike Riley, calm, cool, and collected on the sideline for the moment. 1st down for Minnesota. See what the Gophers can do with their second chance here. Leidner on the keep. And Leidner brought down by Aaron Williams near the 38-yard line, but Leidner on 1st down, able to pick up 6.
Kevin, Mitch Leidner, when you watch this team, when Mitch Leidner is on, it's a really good offense. His problem has just been consistency. He's not been consistent at a high level. There's sometimes he'll have a great 1st half and not so good in the 2nd half. He's got to have a consistent night if they're going to do anything.
On 2nd down, Leidner on the keep again. And Leidner, nowhere to go. Akinmolden right there. The defensive end not going to bite on the fake.
That's a nice job by Akinmolden, just keeping his ground. See him on the top side, stay square shoulders. Now run him down. That's really well done. He doesn't get turned. His hips don't get out. He stays square to the line of scrimmage. Go make the play. Really well done. I'll go with freedom.
3rd and 6 at the 40-yard line. Four-man pressure from Nebraska. Leidner with time, deflected away, and there's a flag. And there's 2, and there's 3. Wolitarski, the intended receiver, Aaron Williams on the coverage.
You'll hear Wolitarski's name all night long. They have great confidence in going to him. Wolitarski knows how to play the position game.
Defense, number 24. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic 1st down.
That's 2 first downs, Matt, that Nebraska's given Minnesota on this opening start to the game, thanks to a penalty.
And that, you know, Aaron Williams is on top of the coverage. That's good coverage all the way around. But his left hand probably hooked him. Let's take a good look at it. You're going to see right there. Yeah, see, his left hand is what they called on. That's a tough call. But they called it.
This is Shannon Brooks in motion. And Brooks on the flip. Turn in the corner. Bowling over Nate Gary to the 21-yard line. Brooks picks up 9.
Shannon Brooks. Shannon Brooks and Rodney Smith are kind of the same guy. They both have great little, they can make you miss. They have ability to be in space, to, they're space players. Shannon Brooks, when you talk about them, you and I were talking about earlier, Shannon Brooks sounds like a smaller guy than Rodney Smith, but it's really the other way around.
Brooks 6'2", 210, Smith 5'11", 205. Second and one at the 21. Here's Brooks, the power back up the middle, gets the first down to the 19. Joshua Kalu on the stop, but Minnesota taking advantage of 12 men on the field, called against Nebraska when they were ready to punt it away. They get another first down on a third down pass interference call, and now first and 10 in the red zone.
One thing about this Minnesota offense, they will not get out of character. They will stay with Brooks. They'll stay with Smith, and then Liner will carry it. They need something to the outside. They're going to go to Walatarski.
On first down at the 19, play action. Liner finds his tight end, Wozniak, and Wozniak dives for another first down at the 8.
All 6'10" of them. Wozniak, that's a nice throw. So they're on top of everything. They understand you're going to get that. Liner's going to give him the boot action. Wozniak back inside, so they took, what they ended up doing was they took Walatarski and cleared that area with him.
First and goal at the 8. Running room for Brooks, who's down near the 3-yard line. Akinmolidun on the stop for Nebraska. Second and goal.
This offensive line of this Gopher team, they got 3 sophomores on that left side. Denell Green, 73, Weiler, 62, and Tyler Moore, 77, the center. Those are all just sophomores. They've gotten better as this season's gone on.
Second and goal. Brooks again. Not getting there this time. Third and goal. May have lost a half yard back near the 4-yard line. Mick Stoltenberg at the bottom of the pile. .88% efficiency in the red zone this year for Minnesota, 5th in the Big Ten. 29 of their 37 scores have been touchdowns. They have the 3rd best touchdown percentage in the conference.
A nice opening drive for the Gophers.
On 3rd and goal, Brooks in motion. Smith to carry. Smith with the touchdown.
Beautiful redirect right in the middle of that thing. The feet in the hole, that's what it is, Kev. He redirected beautifully. You're gonna watch it right up, right there. Boom, now redirect. Few guys make that cut. Smith's one of them who can do it.
Two critical penalties against Nebraska in that drive. And Minnesota cashes in a march of 14 plays to get the touchdown. And the extra point by Emmett Carpenter is good. 7:27 remaining in this first quarter. Rodney Smith's 14th rushing touchdown of the year as his quarterback fired up early. Rushing touchdowns of the year for Rodney Smith. Our Jimmy John scoring drive was a good one. 14 plays, 75 yards, took 7:33 off the clock. The longest scoring drive in terms of plays and in time of possession this year for Minnesota, and the longest drive allowed by Nebraska in terms of time of possession. And before Tommy Armstrong and the offense even gets on the field at Memorial Stadium, half the first quarter is gone.
Yeah, that's exactly what Tracy Clays and his staff could have drawn it up to be. That's exactly what they wanted it to be.
And that's why they took the ball when they won the toss.
There you go.
So a 7-0 lead for Minnesota. What a start on the road for the team that controls its own destiny in the Big Ten West. goes out of bounds. That is the seventh kickoff that Minnesota has kicked out of bounds this year.
Out of bounds.
In a word,
placed at the 35-yard line.
Pathetic.
Right hash. First down.
Only Vanderbilt has done it more. 9 kickoffs as Tommy Armstrong makes his way onto the field for the Cornhuskers, and he stands behind the line. There's only allowed 6 sacks, but that's not the whole story.
That's only about a quarter of the story. This offensive line, not a strong offensive line, but Tommy Armstrong gets out of trouble. His feet have been the reason there hasn't been many sacks.
Quick sway to Westerkamp. Nice move as Westerkamp picks up 6 to the 41. He's playing behind a retooled offensive line is Tommy Armstrong. Gerald Foster has made the start tonight for the Huskers. He'd had his MCL go in camp this year and just got back this week. It was a huge surprise that he was practicing. Now he's starting.
And just a sophomore, but a talented guy. And an athletic guy, and it gives them more athleticism in that offensive line.
Kale Wilbon, the motion man, and he'll get the toss. Wilbon to the edge, and Wilbon with a first down into Minnesota territory. Winfield and McGee on the stop as we check out tonight's Auto Owners Insurance Impact Players.
Well, it's pretty simple to see. You're going to see Newby, the running back. He has to have himself a good night here tonight in the run game. Westerkamp is the guy who moves the chains. And Antoine Winfield, he's the guy who has really come on strong. Just a freshman. Excellent in the run game and also the pass game as well.
On first down and 10. Again, the swing. This is Pearsonell. And Namorne Pearsonell couldn't get around Jalen Myrick, who did a good job of fighting off the block on the edge.
Yeah, Myrick did an outstanding job. Got off the block and forced that thing back inside. But here's the thing. If Tommy Armstrong in this offense, if you're going to give him room out there, they're going to take it. It's simple. They're just going to throw it to you. You're not going to cover him. You're going to give 5 yards. He'll take it.
Second down and 10. Jalen Myrick. Two receivers to the top of your screen for the Huskers.
We're playing off.
Here's Newby. Nice cut. Newby just tripped up at the 41-yard line by Duke McGee.
So, the difference between tonight's game and just a week ago, and it's speed. And so Ohio State a week ago had speed to burn, and they couldn't overcome it. Tonight they're not seeing that. And they're taking advantage of opening this field up by getting to the edges first. Now Newby's trying to take advantage of the inside game.
Third and 3. Huskers one of the best in college football on third down this year. Armstrong gonna run. First time we've seen him use the wheels. And he gets the first down and more. Tommy Armstrong inside the 25 and down at the 22.
That's what you can't account for, Kevin. There's a flag down. So you can take care of everybody except for the feet of the quarterback. You have to dedicate somebody to Tommy Armstrong.
That penalty behind the play at about the 16-yard line.
Enter the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense, number 15. 15-yard penalty to be added on the end of the run. The pushback. His first unsportsmanlike conduct penalty of the game.
Let's check in with Rick Pizzo in Chicago. He's got a BTN studio update.
Number 2.
Well, Kevin, one of the big 4 has fallen. Clemson goes down to Pitt. Chris Blewett, 48 yards in the final 10 seconds. Big news for Ohio State, Penn State, and Wisconsin.
Blewett!
Oh, a huge upset there, Rick. Thank you very much. Here, Nebraska gets derailed a bit by the penalty, but it was a post first down penalty. See at the very top of the screen.
Yeah, all at the top of the top corner up here. That was just didn't stop. He who pushes last gets penalized.
Here's Tommy Armstrong. And Tommy will lose a yard and a half back to the 39. Jack Lynn on the stop.
That's a nice open field tackle by Jack Lynn, who's really kind of the leader of that defense. He's a guy that they count on to get everybody lined up. He's got great leadership skills. And they're a little thin in that linebacking core. Lynn can play all the positions. Got to account for Tommy Armstrong's feet here on this second and long.
Ethan Carter, and Carter brought down by Ray Buford. The freshman makes a good tackle on the much bigger tight end at the 35-yard line.
Yes, Ethan Carter, number 11, is a player that I think is underutilized in this offense. I think he's a talented guy. I think you'll see more and more of him. It looks like he's going off now. Look, got a little hitch in his get-along right there.
Yeah, he's had the elbow issue. You saw the brace on that. Third and eight for the Husker offense. Armstrong to the air. DeMarne Pearson out hit immediately by Jalen Myrick, short of the first down.
That's a good tackle. Myrick closed on that thing quickly. Again, they're playing off a little bit. See how they're giving them you. Now, how you do when you play that off, you're seeing the receiver and you're also simultaneously seeing that quarterback. When you start to see him start to make the throw, that's when you make the break. Myrick did it well.
After a momentary glimpse at perhaps deciding to go for it, Nebraska's going to run on and try a field goal. This of 46 yards for Drew Brown. And Brown right down the middle to get the Huskers on the board. 10th made field goal of the year for Drew Brown. 7-3 Gophers. From Minnesota on today's installment of Dr. Pepper Tradition of the Game, we talk red helium balloons. They started releasing these after the first Cornhusker score sometime in the 1940s, but every score that comes to start the game, the Memorial Stadium sky is filled. Well, that's not a balloon. It's not a space station either. It's the moon, filled in a sea of red helium balloons, sponsored by Dr. Pepper. It's a tradition. 7-3 lead for Minnesota. Over Nebraska, Huskers will kick off. Deontay Harden, 6 yards deep, down to a knee for the touchback. 2:42 to go in this first quarter. Quick break. When we return, second offensive possession for the Gophers. Basketball seasons converge. That means you've got to subscribe now to BTN Plus. You're going to gain access to hundreds of non-televised games, including men's basketball. Monthly and annual passes are available starting at $9.99. Get yourself some BTN Plus right now, available on BTN to go. You'll see Nebraska and Minnesota on BTN Plus coming up this week. Second offensive possession for Minnesota. On first down, the give is to Brooks, and Brooks not finding any running room this time. Josh Banderas, who's had 4 straight games, Matt, with 8 or more tackles, gets one there on Brooks.
Yeah, he's the one linebacker, Banderas, 52, that has some good size. 240 to 45 pounds, runs decent. He's really, from tackle to tackle, he's pretty darn good. But what I really like about him is he believes his eyes. When he sees it, he attacks it. And like you saw right there, it came downhill quickly.
Second down and 10, Huskers blitz. Leidner to the air, finds his man Carter, and Carter dropped after a gain of almost 6. Aaron Williams on the tackle.
Leidner getting up slow.
Also limping is Jonah Persig.
Yeah,
and Persig had missed 3 games this year. He was injured against Iowa.
Injured player.
And now he came, after coming back last week to start against Purdue, Persig down again. That's a huge part of their offensive line, both from a talent standpoint and a leadership standpoint.
Yeah, and from just sheer size. He's 6'9" and 325 pounds. He's nice and long. Now, they came with a blitz. Persig just got, yeah, he just got fell on for his own teammate. Friendly fire on the inside.
Jared Weiler is the guy that got him from behind. And so now Persig, what a talent he is. Honorable mention, all Big Ten a year ago, starting every game. But it's been an injury-plagued second half of the year for Persig. Third down and 4. Garrison Wright in to take over for Persig.
And they put Calhoun in at guard, so Wright moves out.
On third down, the give up the middle, and nothing there. Ross DeZuris brings Brooks down, short of the first down, and Minnesota will punt.
Zuris came on a slant. That's a nice call by the D coordinator. They slanted to the top side. So whatever their key was, you're going to watch him take the hard inside move. He just comes right down the line. Now, the read was off of Zuris. Leidner probably shouldn't have held. He should have probably taken it out of there and run with it, but didn't.
Last time Minnesota lined up to punt, Nebraska had 12 men on the field. The penalty gave Minnesota the first down, and now a flag is thrown.
False start. Offense, number 50. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
A little movement from Jack Lynn.
Jerry McGinn, the referee, and his crew. Does a good job every game we've had him.
These officials have a lot on their plates, Matt. They've done a terrific job this year. Fair catch signaled and made by DeMornay Pearsonell at the 36-yard line. As we check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
Yeah, business as usual on the sideline in terms of the interactions with the Nebraska athletic training staff and their quarterback, Tommy Armstrong. There's been no need really to pay attention to him as of yet. At one point, wide receiver Jordan Westerkamp went up to Armstrong, gave him a high five and said, "You doing okay, man?" He said, "Yeah, man, I'm all right." So it's simple, normal routine, just as Nebraska wants it with their quarterback from the sideline so far.
Yeah, at least to piggyback on that, I saw Tommy Armstrong this week on Thursday, and they were going to make him wear a jersey, a green jersey, so they wouldn't hit him in practice, and he was not having any of that.
Well, a lot of room to run for Tommy Armstrong here, and a first down at the Minnesota 42, caught by Antoine Winfield Jr. after a huge burst for Armstrong and a Husker first.
Nice read by Armstrong. And so you pick it up and you look back inside and your eyes come on. Now watch how his eyes come up downfield. Nicely blocked to the outside. Then he's got space. It's all Armstrong.
And that'll be the final play of a rapid first quarter here in Lincoln. Minnesota at the end of the first quarter with a 7-3 lead. Huskers on the move when we start the second. In the Big Ten West tonight, Minnesota controls its own destiny. If they win out, they're going to Indianapolis for Nebraska. They need to win out and then hope Minnesota can give them a little help at the end of the season. They will play Wisconsin in the final game of the year. A lot of football to be played left before we all can determine who wins the Big Ten West. On first down, Tommy Armstrong on the keep. And Armstrong tackled by Antoine Winfield Jr. at the 40-yard line. He shrugged off the Stanley Morgan Jr. block to make the tackle.
Kevin, go back with what Lisa said at the beginning of the game when she was talking with head coach. Mike was talking about, Mike Riley was saying, you know, it's a medical decision and how much you use Tommy Armstrong and you throw him right in. Well, I think the answer is obvious. Once they clear you medically, you get out there and play. And he's having a great game so far.
Second down and six. DeMornay Pearsonell, the motion man. Armstrong with pressure coming late. And that one almost intercepted by Jalen Myrick.
Myrick had a great break back underneath on the ball. Was underthrown just a tad. But Myrick was in a trail position and undercut it. Man, this should have been a pick. That's just, you know, here's usually what happens, Kev. Myrick was probably a receiver at one time, and that's why he's not anymore. He's a DB.
Should mention that Minnesota, a man short in this half on the defensive side. Nick Rollis, their senior middle linebacker, was called for targeting a week ago in the second half. He's out for this first half tonight. Third down, Armstrong. With some time, throws it. Morgan with the catch, trying to fight for the first down, and he's going to end up about 2 yards short, thanks to Ray Buford hanging on to make the tackle.
Yeah, Buford did a nice job, and Morgan, they went nice tight coverage right across the board. That's what you have to do. Tommy Armstrong had time to be able to make the throw, but they made the nice tackle and sets up this fourth down.
And they're going to go for it here at the 35-yard line.
I would expect to see the same thing, nice tight coverage. Let's see if we don't get a pick or a rub. Offensive people call it rubs. Cheaters.
Fourth down and two.
And now he's giving him lots of room down here. I don't understand that.
Armstrong.
There it is.
Swing pass and a ton of room down the sideline. Trey Bryant all the way home for the touchdown.
did you say, Kev? Kick her around. That's exactly what they did. Minnesota played off. The wide receiver went to the wide side. He came down inside. He just, nice little rub action. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt.
Now, when you were playing, I don't believe you called it a rub, did you?
Oh, no, I called it cheating.
Huskers will line up for the extra point. Cap on a five-play, 64-yard scoring drive, and Trey Bryant, the true freshman out of St. Louis, Missouri, getting into the end zone. And Nebraska with a 10-7 lead, 13:24 remaining in the first half. Trey Bryant calling a pick, calling a rub. Nebraska will call it six at a 10-7 lead. For Nebraska football tonight, the true freshman Trey Bryant into the end zone.
Yeah, Alonzo Moore on the outside coming down right there. They're going to call it a rub. On defense, you called it a pick. Now, they're just going to get him out in the flat, and it's just a matter of foot speed. But you can't allow yourself to get into that position. You can see Moore is just trying on Celestine, trying to get a pick. Celestine has to anticipate that. Anytime you start to get a grouping of receivers, that's the first thing that has to cross your mind. They're doing it for a reason.
Short kickoff. This one from the 9-yard line. Deontay Harden. A flag is down, and Harden down shy of the 25-yard line. Chris Weber on the stop. We'll see what the flag's about here in the middle of that kickoff return. Jerry McGinn, our referee.
During the return, holding. Return team, number 16. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Well, one thing people have often said to us is, hey, Kevin, Matt, and Lisa, why aren't you more real? Well, tonight you actually get the chance to witness and enjoy this game more real, if you have that, Lisa.
Yeah, right. I'm literally living in virtual reality here tonight. I swear this is a way cooler experience than what I look like right now. But what you need here, this is the first time that a college sports network has broadcasted a college football game in virtual reality. There's four cameras here on the sideline, 180 degrees. It's really cool, a 3D version. What you need is the headset that I had on, a Samsung phone, and the app, and you're good to go.
And then you can be surrounded by Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, and Lisa Byington.
No, you're missing the whole point. So yeah? You take that virtual reality and you make sure they have it around the whole table of food. And then you got like burgers and chicken all over the place. It's just beautiful.
Is it better in virtual reality, Lisa?
It's actually very cool. And the neat thing is that this headset makes it seem like it's your actual human eye. You have a periphery vision and a 180 and 3D vision of this game. And if you plug into it, our audio is streamed. So all the technical problems, ask Matt Millen for all the technical questions,
yes.
Right?
Tweet at him. Rodney Smith out to the 16-yard line. You know, it's almost for Lisa like she's really at a college football game tonight.
No way.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
Third down and six for the Gophers. And this Nebraska defense, after that opening march by Minnesota, has stiffened a little bit.
Walatarski's the guy here on third down. You have to get somebody on him. He's in the slot to the top side, 82.
Leidner over the middle. There's Walatarski. There's a first down and much more. Out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
It's not hard to do, Kevin. Mike Riley knows that. You're going to see him right up top. He's just going to come back inside, sit down. It's a zone. And so he understands his own principles, and all he's doing is sitting down in the middle of the zone. That's what you do. Walatarski sees things pretty quick. 6'3", 220 pounds, runs fairly well, but really understands leverage. He'll be a next-level player.
On first down, hit by Kevin Maurice, and Rodney Smith gets maybe a half yard after the initial contact from Maurice.
Yeah, Maurice is a guy who's pretty solid on the inside. There's a couple guys on the inside that I like in there. When they're playing well, Maurice is one of them. And then you see Carlos Davis, number 96, just a redshirt freshman. Those two guys inside, they're pretty darn good. They're hard to block one-on-one, and they are big body guys.
Second and nine. Widener to the air once more, and that's a little bit too tall. Almost intercepted by Jones off the deflection from the right hand of Eric Carter.
Well, he was feeling pressure and he let it go quickly. And then it took off on him. They did bring him, they brought some pressure. That, with two hands, you had a chance. With one hand, a lot less of a chance. He's going to set up this third and nine.
And I know where you're looking on third and nine.
And they better be looking too, up in that slot again with DeWall Tarski.
Huskers bring a little heat. And that's almost intercepted by Gary at the 47-yard line.
He was trying to get to Eric Carter. But the ball came. He never saw the underneath coverage. You watch this. This thing, look at that. That should have been picked. That should have definitely been picked.
He's got four of them this year. Couldn't pull that one in.
Yeah, Gary was right there. I mean,
Lamorne Personnel awaiting the Ryan Santoso punt. And nowhere to roam this time for Lamorne Personnel. Down at the 12, and the Huskers start deep in their own end. Good tackle made by Blake Cashman. 10-7 lead for Nebraska. Husker ball when we return. The University of Nebraska, no trouble checking out a book. 10-7 Huskers with the lead over Minnesota. 10:26 remaining in the first half. And BTN's got a great doubleheader of action on Monday. First at 7, Caleb Swanigan, 15th-ranked Purdue, hosts defending national champion Villanova. Then it's Northwestern and Eastern Washington. Our coverage starts 7 p.m. Eastern, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN to go. First down from the 12 for Nebraska. Here's Newby. Little hop step, and he gets three to the 15. Demarius Travis on the stop.
It's really interesting for me to watch the inside three of this Husker offense. Gerald Foster, 67, with Utter the center, and Farmer down there, 63. Those three guys have take on that number 96, Steve Richardson, who's pretty darn tough.
Mm-hmm.
And Foster's the guy, first time back. So they've been wanting to see exactly what he can do, and can he hold up through the course of the game.
On second and 7, play action. And that one incomplete, looking for Newby, but Richardson providing the pressure that you just talked about right there, Matt.
And Richardson's tough. Richardson is a big, thick body man. And then watch, you're gonna watch him right inside. What you can't do is let him get to an edge. On the inside, you want to stay square. And see, he gets to Foster right away. Foster gets his hips open, and Richardson just runs right through it.
Third down and 7 at the 15. Flag down, and the Huskers moved early.
All start. Offense, number 11. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Third and 12 now, and Minnesota's got Nebraska right where they want them right now. Pinned deep in their own end on a third and long.
He's still going to have to take care of Westerkamp, number one, and then Tommy Armstrong's feet. Armstrong's feet gets him out of a lot of trouble and buys him time. So you want to try to keep him in that pocket and make him a pocket passer.
Newby in motion. They set up the inside screen to Alonzo Moore, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, man, that was not a good series for the Huskers. Yeah, sometimes, you know, when I was in San Francisco, Steve Young was my guy, and The youngster would sit, and all he'd do is watch tape, and all they'd do is watch film of their quarterback's feet. And he would watch nothing but their feet, and at the end of the game, he'd say, I had a good game or a bad game, based on nothing of the throw, just all of his feet.
Lightborn to punt, pressure coming, he gets rid of it. Short punt. That ball may have hit a Gopher. Minnesota diving on it just to make sure at the 46-yard line. And a pretty good play in all that traffic by Jacob Huff, the 44-yard punt, and no return on the play. 9:33 remaining in this first half. Did this one get a piece? Gophers certainly acted like it did. Yeah,
it did. Right there.
It hit him, and he was fortunate to pounce on it and keep the possession for the Gophers. Football on BTN is brought to you by Cialis.
Let's go back and look at that. You're going to watch number 17. He's right up here. It's Jacob Huff. The Huff gets hit right there and has the wherewithal and understands that that's a live ball once it hits him. And so that's why it takes this reaction from him. He knows he's got to get on that thing to cover it, and he does just that. So good awareness by Huff and the recovery.
And the best start for the Gophers tonight at their own 46-yard line. Play action. Widener, the late pressure, and the lob is deflected and incomplete. He had Tyler Johnson, who made the adjustment on Chris Jones.
And so he's going for that back shoulder. I'm assuming that's what it is. Either that's a really underthrown ball. But he had him regardless. Watch him make the adjustment to the top side. Go by. Now go back and get the ball. It should have been a completion. Instead, it was close to being an interception.
On second and 10. Widener on the keep. DeZuris was right there, and he turned him back inside for no gain. That's the second time tonight that DeZuris has played that well.
Yeah, DeZuris has done this. That's the second. You're right. Stayed square to the line of scrimmage, and it gives you as a defender the opportunity to go either way instead of getting your hips or shoulders turned, and it locks you into one direction. DeZuris has done a nice job of staying square to the line of scrimmage and making a couple plays.
Former walk-on who earned a scholarship before his junior year, now a senior out of Plattsburgh, Nebraska. Third and 10 for the Gophers.
Nice tight coverage on the outside.
Leidner with protection, looking downfield, and guess who? Drew Walatarski again.
The shock, huh? Walatarski, we told you at the start of the game that he was going to be their chain mover. He doesn't have great speed, but he's got good speed. But what he understands is leverage. You see how he worked that defender, Kevin? That's called leverage. You have him to the inside, you push to the inside, then work back outside. And when in that little bit of separation, that's where you win.
17-yard pickup and a first down. And on the draw, Smith breaks one tackle and fights forward near the 34-yard line. Akinmola doing on the stop for Nebraska.
Yeah. Rodney Smith, the last four games, really has been on a tear. You can see over 100 yards. You can see all the scores, 127 yards a game, six yards rush. That's as good as there is in the Big Ten Conference.
Yeah, you hear a lot about Saquon Barkley, justifiably
so, should.
At Penn State. Rodney Smith, about to get over 1,000 yards on the year. Smith, peering forward, breaks a tackle,
oh, nice.
And Smith all the way down the sideline. Smith bangs out of bounds inside the two. Chris Jones saves the touchdown.
Now, one thing, there's only one thing. That's an outstanding effort by Smith. But if he would have slowed up just a little bit at the end and allowed his blocker to complete the block, or at least give him something. Look at the nice cut to the outside. See on the top side, you have a blocker. Just let him get there. But that's being nitpicky, because this kid's legit. He's got great feet, makes great decisions, follows his eyes.
First down and goal for the Gophers, trying to regain the lead. Smith. going to get in this time. Second and goal. Michael Rose-Ivy along with Marcus Newby in there on the stop.
Nice job on the inside again. Just with the big people inside with Kevin Maurice, number 55. They don't give much ground in there. You don't see much movement. And that allows those linebackers to be able to come up and clean things up. But the play's made up front.
Second and goal. Again, they try Smith. And again, he stops short at the one. Josh Banderas, there first to make the stop for the Huskers.
Banderas is there. Maurice is there. That's just good, tough football. Don't get beat off the ball. Look at Maurice. Oh, that's really well done. The line of scrimmage is going the other way, and it allows your linebackers to get in there and make plays.
Four straight carries by Rodney Smith. Will he get a fifth?
Where's Walatarski?
Third and goal. Leitner on the key, powering for the goal line, and he is stopped short of a touchdown. Ross DeZuris drove him back inches from a score.
Remember, it's where the ball is. That official is right on that thing. He's looking right down the line.
And the ball.
That's a great call. It's a great call. And it sets up this fourth and inches. Zoris has made some nice plays here.
Mark Banker's defense looking for one more play here.
Timeout.
And timeout Minnesota. Taken by Minnesota.
You have 30-second charge.
Gophers with a huge fourth and goal from the one-foot line when we return. You've got a 6'4", 230-pound quarterback. Fourth and inches to get a touchdown for Minnesota and take the lead. Where do you go if you're the Gophers, Matt?
Well, they've been getting beat at the line of scrimmage on the inside. So if anything, you might want to get to the edge. Or if you're a daring guy and you're Jay Johnson, Walatarski's a guy who understands how to use his body down here.
He's in the slot to the bottom of the screen. Fourth and goal. Leitner on the sneak. Does he get in? It's going to be close. No signal yet. Yeah, touchdown.
Well, that's just power. Tyler Moore, the center inside. That's come off the line of scrimmage down. Look there. I'll tell you, Maurice did a heck of a job there again. There was very, very little movement. That had to be Leitner's just his push. And it was. It was Leitner's push behind that left guard. So that was Weiler 62 that he got behind. And he was able to get it in.
So Leitner with his eighth rushing touchdown this year, number 31 in his career. And Carpenter will tack on the extra point, and the Gophers back on top, 14-10, 4:54 remaining in the second half. Mitch Leitner, his coach knows what he can do, and he knows it's a touchdown. And Mitch Leitner fired up his team with the lead on the road. Lead over 19th-ranked Nebraska, 4:54 remaining in the second quarter. Huge week of basketball ahead as the Gabbett tip-off games get going, and it starts with a dandy. Monday night, 7 Eastern, Villanova and Purdue on BTN. You look down the list of the games on FS1 and on BTN as the Big East takes on the Big Ten in the Gabbett tip-off games. Two storied conferences head-to-head all week long. Minnesota with a 14-10 lead in Lincoln. Huskers have won 18 straight night games, and that one will just sneak across the goal line for the touchback. College football playoff rankings. Clemson losing earlier today to Pittsburgh, 43-42. How about Michigan and Iowa scoreless?
Yeah.
Auburn falls in this one, and Louisville trailing Wake Forest 12-3. A weird day in college football.
This is when you have to be playing your best football. This is as the season's gone on, you want your players to individually get better, and then you want your units to be able to get better.
On first down at the 25, Tommy Armstrong wants to go to the air. Tough throw, and it's incomplete. He was looking for Alonzo Moore. Hendrick Ekpe with the pressure.
Ekpe did a really nice job, and I like the Ekpe brothers. Is Scott and Hendrick there. In this particular instance, it's Hendrick on the outside. He jumps underneath and forces that ball to come out quickly. When you're rushing a guy like Tommy Armstrong, you always have to kind of come under control, because you never know, if he pulls that thing down, he could be off to the races.
Second down and 10. Pressure comes. Ethan Carter with the catch. And Carter brought down first by Demarius Travis before he got some help. A 5-yard gain. Duke McGee there to finish it off.
You know, Kevin, Jerry Kill, head coach here of this Minnesota Golden Gopher team, just sat down just a year ago. He wanted this team to be a physical group. And Tracy Clays has piggybacked on that. And I think you're seeing that. I think you're seeing it on the defensive side. They fly to the football pretty darn well, and they're physical up front, and that's, to me, that's the part that wins games.
Third down and 5 for the Huskers. Pressure coming as Armstrong finds Westerkamp, and Westerkamp with a first down at the 37. Ray Buford on the tackle.
That is on Tommy Armstrong. He knew he was going to get hit right in the kisser, but he just put a bullet right on him. Watch this look. You can see the look right there. He sees the whole thing, and ball comes out right where it's supposed to be.
Rene Pusenel, the motion man. Armstrong on the keep. And not much there for Tommy this time as he gets back to the 37-yard line. Jack Lynn on the tackle. On second down, the screen for Alonzo Moore. Nice little reversal by Moore, and Travis over there to make the stop of the 43. Trying to juke around Jalen Myrick on the outside. Travis came over to close it down after a 6-yard gain.
Well, Demarius Travis, I think, is one of the better safeties in college football. I think he's got great instincts. He runs well. He has good range, and he's physical. And that time, they knew he had a one-on-one on the outside. Travis took a nice angle inside out and was able to make that tackle. That's a good football player.
Third down and 4. Newby in motion. Armstrong on the keep, and Armstrong got shut down by Blake Cashman. Cashman was filling early.
That's huge by Cashman. See, they tried to spread everything out, Kevin, so they motion things out, and it clears the back behind the defensive front. You know, watch as he comes out. Now, there's nothing back here, so Cashman has to be able to make the play. So he works off the center. That's his job. He's got to make it. Once he commits, that's well done by him.
Caleb Light going to punt away for Nebraska. Chenault and Harden back deep. And that went straight up the elevator shaft. And takes a huge Minnesota roll. All the way down near the 42-yard line of Nebraska.
It's like a -4 punt.
-2 officially on the punt from Caleb Lightbourne. And the true freshman can't believe it.
Not a lot of enthusiasm for that kick. Yeah.
Going to play. Sideline warning. Minnesota, their first of the game.
Sky high. And then a bounce you're not supposed to get on your home turf. And Nebraska cannot believe it. Young Caleb Lightbourne, of course, probably wouldn't have been the guy this year but for the tragic passing of former Husker Sam Foltz. First down, Leidner, airing deep, looking for still the jump ball incomplete.
He has not been accurate on this ball all night. It's been, now the coverage has been good, but part of that's because Leidner's hung the ball up. You can't live off of jump balls. That's going to turn around to bite you in the rear end one of these times.
The rushing attack has not been as consistent tonight from Minnesota as it has been in recent weeks.
The only consistent thing we've seen here tonight has been Rodney Smith. And then you've also had Wolitarski. That's been it.
Wolitarski's the motion man. Smith behind Leidner. And Smith the carry on second down. Falls forward near the 38-yard line. Josh Banderas on the stop. Coming up at halftime, Mike Stanley and Howard have all the scores and highlights from the Big Ten action around the world today. That's coming up on the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report.
So you got third and six. So if I am from Nebraska, I'm very aware of Wolitarski. Wolitarski and Smith, those are the two who can make the plays. Take those two away and make them go somewhere else.
On third down, that's Wolitarski in motion. Leidner over the middle, finds Still, and Rashad Still with the first down. Kyron Williams on the tackle, but Still moves the chains.
So that's what they did. And so they gave it to Still, and Still came through. But that's what you do, Kevin. Make them play left-handed, take their best ones away.
And they'll spike that one to stop the clock with 43 seconds to go. Still two timeouts for Minnesota. Second and 10.
They need at least a first here so they can get in good field goal range and try to at least have an opportunity there. Don't have to try to take it to the, you know, throw it to the end zone here. You just want to try to get a first down. And they've been able to have enough protection to be able to use crossing routes here, too. Here's the guy, keep your eye on.
Second down and 10. Draw play for Smith, and he bounces it to the outside. And Smith makes something out of nothing as Tracy Clays takes the timeout. Smith down to the 27. Nathan Geary on the stop. 5-yard pickup.
For second of the half. We have 30-second charge, timeout.
We'll take a quick timeout with them. 14-10, Minnesota. Third down and 5 for Minnesota. 14-10 lead for the Gophers with 35 seconds until halftime.
Yeah, nice.
Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report coming up. Mike Stanley and Howard waiting patiently for this one to head to halftime.
Interesting with Jay Johnson, the offensive coordinator. Right over here. What call he makes here. He knows his playmakers are Wolitarski and Rodney Smith. Smith for space. So if you're defending him again, like you said earlier, take those two away and make somebody else beat you.
Third down and 5. That's Wolitarski in motion. Leidner giving it to Smith. Smith breaks a tackle. And he's short of the first down at the 25. Carlos Davis, along with Michael Rose-Ivy, there to clean up at the end of the play.
Carlos Davis, that big freshman. Good-looking rascal. When he figures out how to play inside there, he's going to be really good. That's a big man. They don't get much push on him.
Minnesota will let this one run down. They'll use their final timeout and put it on the foot of the sophomore Emmett Carpenter.
They'll wait till 3 seconds. There he goes.
Put it down.
Timeout.
1 second.
Minnesota. That's their final charge. Timeout of the half.
Tracy Clay is confident in the timekeeper and the ability to get that timeout called. One tick left for Emmett Carpenter. And 7 field goals for Emmett Carpenter made in the last 2 minutes of either half this season. That is the most in FBS, and he's going to get a chance to add to that number here.
Yeah, we saw Tracy Clays take that timeout. I think Tracy Clays has done a really nice job with his football team. I think his team has gotten better as the season's gone on. I think he knows exactly what his team's capable of. He uses his strengths. He doesn't try to do things that they're not. He knows you know, they're what kind of offensive line he has, what kind of defensive front. I think he's a good football guy.
Here's Emmett Carpenter now. 42-yard field goal for Minnesota. He hit from 52 and 53 a week ago. This from 42. The snap and the hold are good, as is the kick. Emmett Carpenter takes advantage of Caleb Lightborn's miss punt, and Minnesota adds three at the end of the half to take a touchdown lead into the locker room.
If miss punt means shank, I agree with you.
17-10, Minnesota by a touchdown at the break. Mike Riley's Huskers trailing at home, trying to win their 18th straight night game at Memorial Stadium. Down a touchdown at half. For football, Minnesota leading 17-10 as we check in downstairs. Lisa Byington is standing by with Nebraska head coach Mike Riley.
Yeah, Kevin, and part of that lead, Minnesota closed the half with a couple of scoring drives. And you had to deal with a short field on one of those, but ultimately the biggest defensive adjustment would be what for you?
Well, we've got to do a better job on third down. They're making all the third down conversions and keeping the ball, and they've made some pretty long ones too. So we've either got to get a better pass rush, get a little bit better coverage, but that's been a big factor. And then, of course, right off the bat, we hurt ourselves with too many men on the field. Gives them new life, and they score. So we've been our own worst enemy here.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Let's take a look at tonight's Quicken Loans quarterback comparison. Tommy Armstrong, Jr., 127 yards through the air. Mitch Leidner, 109 yards at 43 rush yards for Armstrong and 4 yards and a touchdown for Leidner to their totals in our Quicken Loans quarterback comparison. And it'll be Tommy Armstrong and the Nebraska offense that'll go to work first for Minnesota. The first half possessions, they started with a 14-play drive for a touchdown. Husker defense stiffened, but a couple of short-ish fields for Minnesota on their final two possessions.
Well, that last one with the, you know, that shank punt, that was a big deal. And so they were able to get 3 points out of that. A better punt, and you know, that's not on the board.
For the Huskers, a field goal and a touchdown on their first two possessions, only 21 yards on the final two possessions, but only 4 first half possessions. Minnesota chewing up half of the first quarter with their opening drive. And the second half underway. Trey Bryant from the 2-yard line. Bryant upended just across the 20 at the 21 as we go back downstairs to Lisa Byington.
Yeah, we weren't expecting Tommy Armstrong to run as much as he did in the first half. That's what Tracy Clays told me. He said he looks healthy, but we really thought that they would be a little bit more conservative with him. So what that forces us to do, we got to talk with our coaches on how we stop the quarterback run in the second half.
Yeah, so Lisa, what they'll have to do then is they're going to have to go to assignment football. And you saw at the end of the first half, he's just going to have to assign somebody to Tommy Armstrong on third down.
Mikhail Wilbon and Trey Bryant, the backs, and Bryant with the carry and an excellent tackle by Steven Richardson. Yeah. Big man springing to his left and a 1-yard gain on the play.
Now Richardson's he's a stout guy. I mean, that's a thick man. He's 300 pounds. He's not real tall, but he's powerful. And his first two steps off the ball are pretty darn good as well. And they lost him for a little bit, but he's back and he's playing good football. A
couple of sacks last week in the win against Purdue. Second and 9 for Nebraska. Flag down. This play stops before it starts.
That's going to go against Nebraska.
Ball start. Offense. Number 15. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Fifth penalty for Nebraska.
Yeah, it's personnel down below. You're going to see him. They'll just move. Yeah, just. He realized that he should have been on the line of scrimmage, but he realized it in the middle of the cadence. Not a good time to move.
What was it Mike Riley just told Lisa Byington?
Yeah,
we've been our own worst enemy.
Exactly. Don't beat yourself. That's the old rule.
Second and 15. Armstrong, Westerkamp. And a close play before that one could have broken a lot further. Instead, tackle at the 30 after the 14-yard game. Keontae Harden on the stop.
It'll set up third and one. And so now it's manageable. And now Armstrong's feet coming through. So Westerkamp is, he's the same thing as Walatarski. Those guys, they just know how to work a defender. They know how to get open.
Third down and a yard. Here's Newby trying to wriggle forward and get the first down. He just got it at the 31-yard line. Thomas Barber and Scott Ekpe combine on the stop, but the Huskers move the chains.
Not a lot of work for Newby in the first half.
Just his third carry of the ball game.
Tommy Armstrong really has been the offense. He said as he goes, this offense goes, and that's been right on.
The screen for Westerkamp. And Westerkamp nudged out of bounds by Winfield at the 36. Danny Langsdorf, the offensive coordinator for the Cornhuskers. He's on the right. They've worked successfully to the edge a lot tonight, Matt. We saw that especially early for the Huskers.
Trying to get outside. They're all they're doing is spreading the field, trying to get to inside to loosen up a little bit.
Second and five. Newby tried to cut it back. Pretty good work at the bottom of the pile. Looked like Thomas Barber in there to make that stop. Demaryius Travis also at the bottom of the pile.
Yeah, Barber 41 is interesting. He's got some funk to him. He's got a pretty decent size. Just a freshman. I think he's going to be a good player for them. He's, like I said, he's got a nice physical presence. Minnesota kid out of Plymouth. Nice future.
Third down and three. Here's Armstrong. Pressure coming up the middle. He looks for Stephen Carter, and he's got the first down. Jack Lynn on the stop after the 6-yard gain. Pressure was up the gut from Richardson. Armstrong found his man for the first.
Yeah, good patience. Yeah, you're going to see him right here. Right there. But I want you to watch Armstrong wait till the last possible second. See, he sees him. And the ball comes out. That's just all arm. His feet, he kind of got them out of the way.
Snap to handle. Newby slips through two tackles. And Newby with a first down into Gopher territory. Down to the 44 before Jonathan Celestine can make the stop. A 12-yard gain.
This is exactly what you need. You need somebody else. First of all, not a great snap. But you need somebody other than Tommy Armstrong to start getting a little hot right here. And Newby's the guy right now.
We've not seen him yet on the Gopher defense, but Nick Rollis available to play in this second half. He missed the first half because of a targeting call a week ago. First down and 10. Here's Newby again, and Newby backs his way forward to the 43. A yard is all he's going to get there as Elada Baudere makes the tackle. There's Rollis, the senior out of Edina, Minnesota, trying to get himself back on the field. You know he's eager.
And he's also cold and stiff.
Thomas Barber's been playing well, though.
He has been playing well.
Second down and 9. Armstrong on the keep, trying to weave away from the block of Cotton, and he gets down to the 39. Lynn on the stop.
Well, Demaryius Travis is the guy who made that play. He didn't make the tackle, but he made the play. Tommy Armstrong was trying to get to the outside. Travis came up and took that away and forced him back inside and sets up this important third down.
Tommy Armstrong, 155 yards, only 25 for the rest of the Huskers tonight. Big third and five here.
Watch Westerkamp.
Slot to the top of your screen. That's where Armstrong's looking, and what a diving grab by Westerkamp for the first down.
You got to tighten that up. Got to get your hands on. A little tougher when he's in the slot, but you got to know he's your guy. That's the guy who's going to make those chains move. And so you have to be aware of that the whole time. That's a nice throw. It's low and outside. That's a tough ball to have to stop. And so in order to do that, you got to get your hands on Westerkamp and redirect them.
Third down conversion on the drive. And it's first down. Armstrong wants the screen. Newby's got it. And room to run. Newby.
Kevin, we said at halftime, they have to find somebody else to make a play. I think they just found him. This is just a screen. Armstrong draws the ball in, and then Newby's feet does the rest.
Guys do a little bit of Walter Payton there. Never goes out of bounds, runs through some poor tackling, and it's 6 quick.
A BTN standout play for Terrell Newby. And Newby into the end zone, capping a monster drive of 11 plays, 79 yards, taking almost 6 minutes off the clock. And each team's opening drive of the half has been a good one. Minnesota started the game with a march, and now the Huskers march their way in with a little Roger Craig-esque high-stepping. Terrell Newby in for 6. We got a tie ball game in Lincoln. The score tied up 17 apiece, 9:16 remaining in the third. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington. One last look at the touchdown.
Yeah, I'll see what screens are all about timing, Kevin, and feel. And the feel has to come from the quarterback, and he played it perfectly right there.
Deontay Harden takes the knee in the end zone for the touchback, and out it comes to the 25-yard line for Minnesota. The Gophers have been in a lot of tight games this year. Mitch Leidner, 5 games so far, decided by 7 points or less. Look at the opening drives of each half tonight. Yeah. Minnesota on the march, Nebraska with a march. How will Mitch Leidner answer what Tommy Armstrong was able to do a moment ago? Engineer that touchdown drive for the Huskers. Smith, the running back. Leidner finds Clinton Beebe, and Beebe down to the 31-yard line. A pickup of 6. Aaron Williams on the stop.
They're just trying to get to the edge. You know, lost it all this. Piercy has come back in, and it has been in since the middle of the second quarter. And then they've moved right from tackle back down the side of the guard. That's their best offensive line. So the 3 sophomores to the left and 2 upperclassmen to the right gives them their best chance.
2nd and 4. Met by Banderas and driven back. Rodney Smith saw a hole and Banderas closed it quick.
Yeah, he looked like Antonio Banderas on that one.
Suave.
He's just, you know, I want you to watch this. Watch what he does. He sees, once he sees and diagnoses it, he attacks it. And this is called coming downhill. That's exactly what that is. That's really well done by Banderas. Well played, well executed.
On 3rd down, pressure coming. Leidner got rid of it. Nice. What a catch by Drew Walutarski.
Walutarski leveraged him, and the ball was in a small window, Kevin. That's a heck of a throw by Leidner. But Walutarski, again, using his body. You're going to give him the outside, he'll take the outside. He'll just stay to the inside. And what that does is it puts a lot of pressure on the thrower. The ball has to be perfect, and it is.
What a grab.
That's a heck of a throw by Leidner.
On 1st down, here's Smith with the carry. And Kalu the tackle at the 36-yard line, a loss of 1. Some jawing occurring a little more frequently now after these plays. physical, hard-fought game with a lot on the line for these two teams.
Very similar teams. Very similar. I mean, if you look at how they're put together, they're virtually the same group. Both has a good receiver. Both have another runner, Tommy Armstrong and then Rodney Smith. And then the third guy has got to make a play. In this case, it's Widener.
Widener to Wolitarski, and a rare drop by Drew Wolitarski. The West to be won in the next couple of weeks. Wisconsin, the team to chase right now. But again, we've talked about it throughout the broadcast. Minnesota controls the destiny in the West. If the Gophers win this week, next week against Northwestern, and at Wisconsin to close the year, Minnesota, your West champions.
Yeah, Minnesota has the toughest road to go.
Gophers are 6 of 11 on third down tonight. But this is third and 11. Wolitarski in the slot to the bottom of the screen. Pressure coming. Widener breaks away. Cannot get away from Michael Rose Ivy. Antonio Reed was the first guy to get there. And then Michael Rose Ivy finished it off.
Good coverage also. They jumped the coverage of Wolitarski. Even with that, he wasn't going to have enough time to be able to find him. That's just a good pass rush that time.
Santoso gets off a good one. Pearson out all the way back to the 9-yard line. Pearson out. Gets to the sideline. Now trying to reverse his field, and he'll be down shy of the 20-yard line. Huskers trying to put a little heat on Mitch Leiter. Able to get it done on this one. Nebraska's offense back on the field in a tie game. Tommy Armstrong and the Husker offense getting set to start another drive. This one from their own 17-yard line. Tommy Armstrong, most career wins as a starter among active Power 5 quarterbacks as of right now. Tommy Armstrong with 29 wins, leads all Power 5 quarterbacks in wins, looking for number 30 tonight. A long way to go in this one, a 17-17 ball game with 5:54 to go in the third. You saw Leitner back there just a few wins behind. Two of the winningest in Power 5 on display here. Armstrong on the roll on first down. That's a first down.
That's a rope too, man.
Alonzo Moore on the grab. Winfield on the stop. 14-yard pitch and catch.
Tommy Armstrong's a difference in this football game right now. And his feet, his ability to move, ability to buy time, and he is throwing some ropes right now. And that is, he put that thing right on the money.
Now, any questions about his health have been put to rest tonight. Morning, Pearson L on the jet swing. And caught at the 40-yard line by Winfield.
Yeah,
that's one thing the coaches wanted to do, is get him more involved. We talked with him yesterday, and they said he's been underutilized a little bit.
Yeah, they're trying to get him to the edge. And, you know, a week ago they tried to do that thing, but Ohio State speed shut it down. Here he's able to do it. And Antoine Winfield, if he doesn't run as well as he does, Pearson L's still going.
Second down and a yard. Play clock winding down. It's at 5. On second and one, Armstrong. Over the middle for Moore. Incomplete at the 30. Good coverage by Keontae Harden.
And Moore should have had it. That ball was there. He had position. The ball presented itself. He was able to get it with his hands. This should have been a completion. Yeah, you got to come back to that thing. Reach with your hands and come back to it. The defender, you know, is going to come back to it, or, you know, work through you. You got to go attack the ball.
Three tight ends for Nebraska. Armstrong on the sneak on third and one. And he just sidled his way for the first down.
Sidled. How do you sidle?
You just sort of sidle up.
I've heard saddled.
Yes, they're saddling, but this is sidle. You know, he just sort of sidles you.
Mitchell's
Tommy Armstrong
player.
Is still down on the field.
That's what happens when you sidle.
Boy.
They can't afford to have him hurt. He's holding that
left leg,
left ankle. He has been the difference in this football game. There's no question about it.
Unlike most weeks, this was certainly not like most weeks for Nebraska in the quarterback department. Ryker Fife took a lot of snaps this week for Nebraska in anticipation that he might need to start. Let's see if we can see what happened with Tommy. Watch the left ankle.
It looks like it just gets pinned under there.
Merrick Jackson was one of the guys in there at 320 pounds. And take another look at it here. Tommy is up. Not putting a lot of weight on that ankle.
At least he's walking on it. Maybe it was just scared. Maybe he was scared.
Check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
Well, Kevin, scary and surreal is how Tommy Armstrong's family described his injury last week, and now for the second straight weekend, they got to watch him take a tumble to the turf. 45 minutes, we were really nervous at Jalen Oderman, that's his fiance. On the field, he just wasn't acting like himself last week, so when we came back to the hospital with him, it was very comforting to eventually see him become who Tommy was. But now, like I said, second straight weekend, they got to watch him get tended to by the athletic training staff.
Yeah, you've got to be more than a little nervous. There's Jalen Oderman, Tommy's fiance, watching from the seats as they tend to Tommy on the Husker bench. Second down and 11.
So the run threat is completely gone. Fife is not the same guy.
Second and 11. Fife to the air, low throw, looking for Westerkamp. Did he make the catch? They're going to rule it a catch on the field at the 45.
Let's see if he caught this ball. No, he didn't. It's incomplete.
They'll have a chance to look at this one.
Previous play is under further review. The ruling on the field was a reception.
That's going to get reversed. And it'll bring up third and long for the Huskers.
Now his hand is not under it. It does hit the ground. I don't believe there was control. Right there, that's a great shot. That one right there is the most definitive. He kind of traps it from the top. My guess is they'll call us an incomplete pass.
There's Tommy Armstrong.
Yeah, they're taping it up. Get that nice and tight. And a little adrenaline kicks in, and pretty soon he's running around.
That's what Husker fans are hoping. I'm assuming Gopher fans would be just fine if Tommy were back in full strength, say, next week when Maryland came to town. See the official there with the notepad out. Mike Pereira taught us a few weeks ago that that's one of your keys to watch during these replay reviews. When they've got the pad out, usually a reversal is coming.
Yeah, well, what they're doing is getting their time. They're getting the time. Getting the time, what should be on the clock, all that kind of stuff. And then,
well, Mike Pereira is with us in our studios. And Mike, just to prove that we listen to you, we're watching our keys, and we see the man with the notepad. This one's coming back, isn't it?
I have no secrets left, for God's sakes. You know, this one. I mean, Matt is right. I mean, you don't have a hand under the ball, so actually that means really he used the ground to help him complete the catch, and you can't do that. As you can see, there's no hand underneath the ball. And you're right. And when you're going to reverse,
it was an incomplete pass. The ball was placed at the 40-yard line at the previous spot, left hash, clock operator. Please put 337 on the game clock. Thank you.
Mike Pereira, thank you very much. Always
Professor
good to have Mike
Professor
Pereira join us here on our as our rules analyst. There's Tommy Armstrong off the bench, walking around a little bit. Testing out that ankle. Riker Fife on third and 11.
That's a medical decision before he comes back. That's not a coaching decision.
On third and 11. Pressure coming. Fife in trouble. And Fife is sacked. Blake Cashman gets to the quarterback for the first time tonight. The fourth sack of the year for Cashman.
Okay, so that just goes, let's go back to what we talked about. Only six sacks in the season. That's why. Tommy Armstrong would have been off to the races. Cashman closed quickly. Fife went down. That's the second big play Cashman's made on the quarterback here tonight.
See Tommy continuing to try to loosen that ankle up. And Chenault back deep awaiting the punt. Good fair catch called for and a good recovery by Lightbourne after the disappointing punt at the end of the first half. Lightbourne sends that one to the 24-yard line. Gophers on their way out after a fine defensive play by Cashman. The offense takes the field next. Tied 17 apiece, 2:50 remaining in the third in Lincoln. As the Gophers go to work. First down and 10 at their own 24-yard line. On first down, Leiter to Wolitarski. And Wolitarski, a good gain on first down as he picks up 9. Williams and Williams combined on the stop for the Huskers.
Yeah, I just don't understand. Well, I guess on first down I understand it, but you want to try to tighten that up. I think Williams and Wolitarski is a plus for Wolitarski right now. He's been working him pretty well, and I think he's pretty confident he can beat him. When you have a body guy like Wolitarski, you have to be physical with him.
Second down, here's Brooks. And Brooks driving forward gets the first down. Nathan Gary there on the stop, but not before Brooks moves the chains.
Yeah, Nathan Gary and Banderas there. Those two guys tonight have played really solid football games. Banderas made a couple of really nice plays. Gary, they're dropping down. Missed a pick early. That was a great opportunity for this team, but he's been active in the run game. They've been dropping him down in the box all night long. Let's keep our eyes right here again.
From the 35, is Brooks trying to get to the outside. And Banderas over to make the tackle at the 41.
So even in the run game, you keep your eyes on Wolitarski because he's a good blocker. Keep in mind, he's 220 pounds. And his guy, who he's got to take out, is that safety dropping down. You're going to watch him down inside. You're going to see he's going to go dig this guy out. Right there. He takes Williams. He's just going to, that's called digging a guy out. You go in, you got to go find him, hunt him up, and take him down.
7 catches for 87 yards for Wolitarski. Second down and 4 for the Gophers.
See that fake on the top side of down below here with that Brooks. And then here comes Gary.
And there's Brooks with the carry. Tripped up as he gets to the 42-yard line by Nick Stoltenberg, and it's third down.
Third down, near Nebraska. The guy who's moved the chains all night long. So there's two guys right now. You have to be careful. So Shannon Brooks is one, and the other one's Wolitarski. Make somebody else beat you. Those two can't beat you. Wolitarski's in a slot to the top side.
Second 6 of 12 tonight on third down of the Gophers. Leidner under pressure. Leidner gonna run, and Leidner's got the first down.
They were ready for his feet, and Leidner still beat him.
And another conversion on third down.
Leidner, it's man-to-man. Leidner sees it, and he's just using his feet. He's able to beat him to the edge and get that first down.
And that's the final play of the third quarter in Lincoln. A dandy brewing here. 17-17 through three.
Tommy Armstrong from the sideline. He is showing no signs of pain, of grimacing. This is the first time that he's actually taken a seat. He was walking up and down. He was jogging up and down, trying to keep that ankle loose. You saw him trying to get it taped up. It went pretty high on that left ankle, guys.
All right, Lise, thanks very much. Great fake by Leidner as he finally found Rashad still for a 9-yard gain on the play. Chris Jones on the stop.
Yeah, I mean, what he had was good protection. And they shifted, they kicked to a 3D. So he looked deep first, and it wasn't there, and he was able to come back underneath and set up this second and one. Good well done by Leidner.
Good protection tonight of Leidner. He has not been sacked. Minnesota's only allowed 9 sacks all year long.
Well, Nebraska doesn't have a guy who can get after the pass rusher.
Second and one, here's Brooks. And Brooks is not going to get there. In fact, he'll lose yardage. Back to the 45-yard line as we check in with Rick Pizzo in Chicago on the BTN studio update.
All right, Kev, Iowa hanging tough with number 3, Michigan. Perfectly designed screen pass. Akram Wadley on the score. Iowa misses the 2-point conversion. Hawks trail the Wolverines by 2 at the half.
Oh, Iowa, Kirk Ferentz bouncing back from a rough night at State College a week ago.
There's a big third down right here. Watch, you have to account for Leidner's feet in this situation also.
Rodney Smith, the running back. Now third and 2, it's Smith. And Smith will go nowhere.
They just won the line of scrimmage. It goes the other way. Watch the line of scrimmage. It doesn't move at all. That's Maurice in the bottom of that pile. Just played. I think he's played a heck of a game here today. Very physical, not giving anything.
Big stop for Nebraska. Santoso will play the field position game for Minnesota and try to pin the Huskers deep. Monet Pearsonell with the fair catch near the 10-yard line. Husker offense going to work, and so is Tommy Armstrong. Tommy Armstrong looks like he's about ready to come back out on the field. And, you know, we went back into the archives. When you look at Tommy Armstrong, a passing touchdown, a rushing touchdown at 17 career games. 1907, this is how the Nebraska yearbook described what a quarterback should be for college football, specifically at Nebraska. To run fast, to dodge, and twist your way through a broken field is expected of a quarterback. And then it said many other things in very flowery language because that's how they did things in 1907. When you look at the Husker quarterbacks over the years and to the present day, they've kind of followed that 1907 guideline. And Tommy Armstrong getting a huge ovation as he comes back out onto the field. To run and dodge and do all those things that were expected of him. First down, here's Newby, and Newby can't get away from Richardson, who makes the stop at the 11-yard line.
Who's played himself a pretty darn good football game here tonight. You know, like you said, he was out of the lineup for a little bit, but he's just a powerful guy, and he's tough to block. He's tough to single block. And when you leave him alone, he's going to win that battle. And so far tonight, he's controlled the inside.
Second down and 8. Strong to the air. Demone Pearsonell reversing his field. And Demone Pearsonell with a huge play across the 40 before Keontae Harden can catch catch up to him.
That's the first semblance of speed we've seen outside of Tommy Armstrong. And they need to utilize that. And he did. And simply, you're going to see him. He's just going to go in. He's come right back out. So he's anticipating the hit to the inside and spins to the outside and then hits that other gear. Well done.
29 yards later, a first down at the 40. Personnel on the jet sweep. And Devonte Personnel to the 43-yard line. Celestine on the stop.
I think two guys who have played pretty good football games here tonight from the linebacker side. One is Banderas on one side, and on the other side for Minnesota has been Celestine. Celestine, I like his game. I think he's got a nice little mean streak going there. He plays with that kind of nice attitude.
Second down and 8 for the Huskers. Here's Newby out of the eye. And Newby fighting through tackles. Look at Newby powering to midfield.
This is well done, keeping his balance. And then once the other guys start giving you that extra push, you just got to stay up. And he's did a good job of that.
Haven't seen Armstrong use the wheels yet.
No.
Since he came back in. Pressure coming. They set up the screen for Newby with a flag down. And Newby upended on a nice tackle by Winfield at the 43-yard line. Pressure from Galen Elmore, and that's where the flag was thrown.
Holding. Offense, number 67. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's Gerald Foster in his first game of the year.
Yeah, we checked in with him earlier, and he'd been holding his ground pretty well. That time he needed a little extra help. Gonna watch him, number 67. Yeah. I don't see that one. I've seen worse. Let me put it that way.
You've experienced worse.
Yeah. Nick Rollins is back in.
There's Rollins right there.
56.
Out the first half of the game after a targeting call a week ago. Here's the morning. And he makes something out of nothing as he gets out to midfield. Rollins on the stop.
Kevin, I don't know who flashed there, had a chance to get a pick. And I don't. Personnel ended up making the catch, but somebody flashed. Somebody read it really fast and jumped it and just missed that thing.
Second down and 11. Complete. Riley thought he had it. Jalen Myrick on the coverage, and the officials will say incomplete.
It's a heck of an effort. One hand, and that's a great call by the officials, right on top of it. Yeah. Riley goes up, great concentration, just couldn't quite finish the deal. Ooh, I don't know, looked a little different from that side, didn't it? The first shot we had looked like it was definitive.
The crowd's seeing on a little bit of a delay on the big screens what we saw.
Yeah, here's now from this angle, it looks like he caught.
Yeah.
It looks like he. Yeah, well, it's not going to matter. They're going to go.
On third down, Armstrong, here as he throws, got it to the sideline, and a sliding grab by Alonzo Moore. What a throw by Armstrong.
That was a phenomenal throw across the field. That's what, 30 yards from across the field on a rope. That's a heck of an effort.
With Cashman hitting his throwing arm as he got rid of it.
That's pretty darn good.
And a fine sliding catch.
Yeah, and his hands underneath it and control it.
Swing pass, Lester King. And a first down. He got an initial block from Riley, then Pearsonell blocking downfield to move the chains, and the Huskers moving it up and down the field to the edges.
Yeah, Riley's was the key. That's the one that got him into the second level. Westerkamp then did the same thing. But you're going to watch, the ball comes out quick. This is how they started the game. There's the first block by Riley, and now Pearsonell at the top end of it. Well done.
Mike Riley was a little hot at the end of that play. He thought there was a little extracurricular on the sidelines. On first down, Newby. Nice little slip, but Newby nearly 10 yards. Demarius Travis on the stop, and Nebraska's got Minnesota off balance right now.
Yeah, and they're working that clock as well. And it's a combination of throwing. It's been all Tommy Armstrong. Now, not his feet, but his throws right here have been on the money.
19 of 25 for 217 yards and two touchdowns for Tommy Armstrong. Second and one. And that one incomplete. He was looking for more. Coverage by Harden, and it's third down.
Now he's looking for a double move is what he was looking for, and it didn't happen. So he did the pump, expected somebody to break on it, and it didn't break. So he just got rid of it. Smart.
So now third and one, 7:45 to go.
Third and one, now you have to account for Armstrong's feet as well. This becomes a little bit of assignment football.
Stelter.
Stelter got his hands up perfectly.
So now fourth and one. 7:42 to go.
You got
to
kick it.
Tie ball game.
He's not going. Yeah, he's not. He's going to go for it.
Staying on the field.
He's going to go for it.
You're turning down what would likely be a relative chip shot for Drew Brown to take the lead, and the Huskers will go.
That's the safe move, but Mike Riley's not going to be safe.
On fourth down and one. Armstrong gives it to Newby. First down.
Trusted the right side of that Husker offensive line. Farmer 63. Cole Conrad 62. They do a nice job. As does Luke McNitt. Does a nice job. That fullback there. Able to pick that thing up.
And a timeout's going to be used by Minnesota.
Timeout.
With 7:21 to go in the fourth, Nebraska marching for a go-ahead score. Memorial Stadium at night has been a difficult place for the visitors over the years. Nebraska trying to continue that. They're 44-5 all-time at Memorial Stadium at night. Huskers and Gophers in a good one. 17 apiece with 7:21 to go. Nebraska with a first down after going for it on fourth and short. And Tommy's fiance looking on as her soon-to-be husband has come back out after an injury to lead this team. And Armstrong on the tee, and Armstrong for the touchdown!
He came up holding, now it looks like he's holding his hamstring. Well, I'll tell you what, while he was carrying it, he was moving it pretty good. He crossed the goal line.
And now he's being carried by his offensive line to the sideline. Foster and Farmer taking the role of guard very seriously as they guard Tommy all the way to the bench. Boy, is that kid battle.
He's played really well here tonight. He has played exceptionally well. He's been the difference in this football game.
265 yards total offense tonight for Tommy Armstrong. And a 91-yard drive, the longest drive of the year against Minnesota, capped by the Tommy Armstrong run. Take the lead.
Oh, his eyes are up. And then the rest of it is just all feet. Tommy Armstrong has thrown some ropes here in the second half, but it's still his feet that make him dangerous. You have to account for him all the time. This one's far from over, Kevin, no question.
Minnesota, we told you earlier, this is a team that has been in close game after close game all year long. They're 3-2 this year in games decided by 7 points or less. And you've got a senior quarterback to lead you in Mitch Leidner. Tommy really struggling right now.
Still have to defend Waltarski. You still have to handle Smith or Brooks. The way to do that is to get good pressure on Leidner.
From the goal line. Deontay Harden stopped at the 15. Brad Simpson gets down there to make the stop. We'll keep our eye on Tommy Armstrong, really struggling with that left leg right now.
Really ginger right now.
Here comes Mitch Leidner. Huskers, the best defensive fourth quarter team in America this year. Just 20 points allowed. And on first down, nowhere to go. Stoltenberg reaching out and grabbing Rodney Smith as he tried to go by. No gain on the play.
Yeah, nice job by Stoltenberg. That's a big man in there, number 44. He does a nice job. He's 6'5", 290 pounds. But this is just manhandling the guard. Not even close. He just took Colt Conrad, got rid of him.
Second down and 10. Leidner on the move. Leidner caught by Banderas as he gets to the 20-yard line, but the feet of Leidner allow Minnesota to get into a third and very manageable.
Third and manageable. But again, it's Banderas who's made the plays, had a great game here tonight. So now it comes down to Leidner. Leidner's decision-making and then trying to get the ball into the play, the hands of the playmakers, which is Smith or Waltarski.
Waltarski's in the slot to the bottom of the screen.
It's smart. Get up there. Get your hands on it.
They'll empty the backfield out. On third down, Leidner to the sideline. Not enough for the first down.
That's four by Shannon Brooks. I'm sorry, Rodney Smith. You got to know where the sticks are. You got to let the guy on the outside clear that area and then get behind it. But don't cut it short.
And the Husker defense. The black shirts get the stop. And Minnesota will punt it away. And will the Gophers get the stop they need from their defense? Ryan Santoso to punt it away. Good punt. Lamorne Pearsonell, an over-the-shoulder bobble, dribbles it off the turf at the 15 and goes nowhere. What a punt by Santoso. Good coverage by Winfield. A boomer down the field, 58 yards. And Tommy Armstrong doesn't look like he's coming out this time.
This is Mike Call here in our BTN studios in Chicago, reminding you, stay where you are. When this game is done, I'm going to be with you to recap everything that happened on the State Farm postgame show. Highlights and reaction a ton from this game between Minnesota and Nebraska. JT Barrett broke an all-time Big Ten conference record. We'll tell you all about that from earlier today. Plus, nationally, some great news for the Big Ten elite teams that are trying to make their way into the playoff picture. All that's coming up when this game is done. But for now, back out to Lincoln and Kev.
Thank you very much. It's been a rough couple of weeks for Tommy Armstrong. You see him up icing that leg. 278 total yards. The rest of the team just 61. But Tommy Armstrong, these last couple of weeks, we saw what happened last week against Ohio State. The injury that had everybody very concerned. Tommy back tonight. And you saw this earlier, an ankle that got retaped on the sidelines as he was helped off. And then on that last play, he takes it in for the go-ahead touchdown and grabs that left leg again, more in the hamstring area this time, and is carried off the field by his guards.
Well, it's low on the hamstring. That's good. But when they're up high, that's tough.
Riker Fife now in at quarterback. A big series for this Minnesota defense as Newby finds a hole.
That hole opened quick, and Newby used his eyes to get to it. Really well done. It's just good blocking up front. Newby took advantage of it, got to the second level. Antoine Winfield has played a good game here tonight, took away a couple of potential home runs.
Find some yardage in the middle of that play at the 46-yard line. Rawlis and Harden on the stop. And a flag in at the end of the play.
End of the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense, number 11. 15-yard penalty. That's his first of the game.
That's Ethan Carter with a huge 15-yard penalty.
Play's over. We have nothing to do. That was a little flop action there from Celestine. He might be getting an Emmy. Or what do you call those things? Oscars.
He could get both.
What? I don't know the difference.
Whatever it was, Celestine ends up getting 15 yards of field position back for his team. First down and 10 with the clock running, 4:05 and counting to go in this one. Nebraska up by a touchdown. Riker Fife in at quarterback for Tommy Armstrong. And Newby again. And this time, nowhere to go. Lynn and Harden both there to make the stop. Tonight's United States Marine Corps leader of the game, Nebraska's Sam Cotton, the senior tight end, will graduate with a degree in marketing and business administration next month, a three-time academic All-Big Ten, and a two-time member of the Brooke Baringer citizenship team at Nebraska. Sam Cotton, our United States Marine Corps leader of the game. Third down and 18. Draw to Newby, and Newby dropped by Galen Elmore at the 35-yard line, and Minnesota will use one of its two remaining timeouts. 3:08 remaining in the fourth, and the Gophers are going to get it back down a touchdown. 24-17 advantage for Nebraska. 3:08 remaining in the fourth. Kevin Kugler alongside Matt Millen with Lisa Byington on the field. Huskers about ready to punt it back to Minnesota, and the Gopher defense got exactly what they wanted. They got the stop, and now they're going to get the ball back with decent field position.
Yeah, what they really got was they got a Tommy Armstrongless offense, and with him out, it's a completely different animal.
Remember tonight, Caleb Lightbourne had a punt of negative 2 yards. Big moment for the freshman here. And a wobbly short punt. It'll take a Nebraska roll, and a good roll, down inside the 30-yard line near the 28. The West up for grabs over the final few games of this season. Wisconsin in the lead at 5-2. Minnesota needs a win to keep pace. Nebraska already lost earlier in the year to Wisconsin. Huskers, to get to Indy, have to win out and hope somebody knocks Wisconsin out.
Yeah. So right now, Kevin, Minnesota, it's four downs. That's the first thing. And now the second thing is the good Mitch Leidner has to show up. It's on him.
He's got Smith with him in the backfield. First down, Leidner, pressure comes. Hit as he throws, sliding grab over the middle. No, incomplete. Wolitarski couldn't get down on that one, and it's second down.
He has his hands under it, but he must not have controlled it when he went to the ground.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. Second down.
Second down. To Smith, and Smith works to the 34-yard line.
That's still good. You're third and manageable, and like I said, here you can use four downs. This is going to be it.
Minnesota pacing a little bit. They've been terrific on third down tonight. Leidner, pressure coming late. Leidner bobbles it, throws it, is caught, and a first down.
That's an awesome play by Mitch Leidner. And he was in the grasp going down, had the wherewithal to dump it off, and got the first down. That's a huge play for Minnesota.
And Banderas is down for Nebraska.
Banderas has played one heck of a football game here tonight. Watch this effort by Mitch Leidner. Yeah, he's going to be in the grasp, has the wherewithal to throw it. Smith, that's a great job. Oh, man.
On first down.
Here comes pressure.
It's picked up. Leidner, a little bit too tall for Johnson, incomplete.
Yeah, he's been high all night long. The ball's been coming off a little bit too much. He's got to bring that thing down. Mitch Leidner, they've lived and died with him. And sometimes he has been absolutely terrific, like we saw on that third down, and sometimes he's just been severely average.
On second and 10. Leidner, late pressure, incomplete. And here comes a flag. He wanted Rashad still. Joshua Kalu on the coverage.
He had an open guy in front of Still. Mike Riley not feeling his penalty.
Pass interference. Defense, number 10. Automatic, first down.
Mike Riley thought the pass was tipped. Was it?
No.
The ball is not tipped. First down.
Yeah, he didn't touch it.
Leidner again. And that one intended for Wolitarski, and he makes the catch at the 42-yard line. Clock running, under 2 minutes to go. Minnesota has one timeout left, down a touchdown.
Need to get lined up right.
Leidner with good protection finds the sideline and broken tackle. Johnson steps through another and he's down near the 15-yard line.
Clock will stop until they bring the chains up.
And Leidner leading Minnesota on a game-tying drive. Can he complete it here? Leidner deflected and intercepted. Picked off by Kyren Williams. Aaron Williams on the deflection. Kyren Williams with the pick. And the Gophers are turned away.
Yeah, the good Leidner and the bad Leidner all in one series.
Yeah.
He tried to force that one inside, and the Williams, not brothers, the Williams duo completed it. He wanted Walatarski. And the first Williams did a nice job of understanding that Walatarski had to be taken away and undercut it. And the other Williams picked it off.
10th interception for Nebraska in the fourth quarter alone this year. For Williams, his fifth of the season. Minnesota only one timeout remaining. Iker Fife in for the injured Tommy Armstrong, who scored the game leading touchdown and then limped off with the help of his guards as Newby pushes the pile to 17. Jackson and Richardson combining on the stop.
Timeout. Minnesota, their final charge. Timeout of the half.
Minnesota using that last timeout with a minute 20 to go in the fourth.
Kevin, we said from the start that these teams are the same team. There's only a few guys who can make some plays. Well, Tommy Armstrong, he handled their playmaking side. And Minnesota had an opportunity, as you can take a good look.
Our Duluth trading hardest working player, Tommy Armstrong, as you mentioned, Matt, he was the difference in this game.
Yeah, he was the difference. And on the other side, we said that Miss Leidner had to be consistent tonight in order for them to have a chance to have the win. And in that second half here, it just wasn't consistent enough.
Huskers 10 interceptions in the fourth and only one touchdown allowed this year. State Farm postgame report straight ahead. Mike Hall has reams of paper that he has written scores on, and he will read all of those scores to you coming up in our State Farm postgame report. He'll do other stuff too, I assume. Riker Fife's going to take a knee. And he does. And the clock will run. Huskers about to move to 8-2 and 5-2 in league play. And the remaining schedules, they've got Maryland at home next week. Then they go to Iowa on the day after Thanksgiving. Northwestern and Wisconsin for Minnesota. And for the Badgers, they're at Purdue this coming weekend. And then they close with Minnesota at home.
So Minnesota gets knocked out of the driver's seat.
And the driver's seat is occupied by a Badger right now.
That's exactly right. And that Badger defense and those linebackers. And I said it last week and I'll say it again. I think Paul Chryst has done a phenomenal coaching job.
And the one turnover tonight ends up costing Minnesota a chance to tie this game up. Tracy Clays and the Gophers fall in Lincoln. Mike Riley's Huskers get a 24-17 win in a game, Matt Millen, that went almost exactly as expected between these two very similar teams.
Yeah, either this was a coin flip game, we said from the start. It followed the script perfectly. And who could make the most plays? Tommy Armstrong is the difference in the game.
And, of course, the questions will already start to come for next week in Nebraska. The same questions as they had this week. Will number four be ready to go next week against Maryland? Knowing what we've seen from Tommy Armstrong, I wouldn't rule it out. Let's check in downstairs. Lisa Byington is standing by with the head coach of the Huskers, Mike Riley.
Yeah, the story was your quarterback, Tommy Armstrong. He had to pass concussion protocol this week. He had to suffer through an ankle injury and now a hamstring injury. How tough is your quarterback?
He is a very, very competitive guy. Every guy on our team, Lisa, respects him to no end. I mean, they all know he's going to battle like crazy. Now, I guess he pulled a hamstring here near the end of the ball game, so we'll see how that goes this week.
You said at the beginning of the game you were going to have to play him a little bit conservatively. How much did you think you would be able to run him tonight?
Well, you know, I think when Tommy plays and he's healthy to play, that's such a big part of his game that it was going to be a 50-50 call deal. You know, it's sometimes, and a lot of it is reading. So some of it works out to him running the ball, some of it doesn't. But we really didn't know exactly how it would play out.
You needed a bounce back performance after the loss to Ohio State. What did you see from your team's fight as a whole?
I think that this This has been a more typical game for the Huskers this year, where we've had to win in the fourth quarter and play our best ball in the fourth quarter. And I think that our guys fought back to get to a point where we could do that and win the game in the fourth quarter. So I'm real excited for them. I think they did a great job of bouncing back from a real hard, tough loss last week. So very excited for this team.
All right. Thank you for the time.
Thank you.
Mike Riley and the Huskers now 5-2 and 8-2. Same record as Wisconsin. Wisconsin, though, the head-to-head, thanks to that overtime win in Madison, Minnesota, and Northwestern now at 4-3. Those two teams will play next week in Big Ten Conference play. That's going to do it for Memorial Stadium, and what a ball game it was tonight. Our final score, Nebraska wins it 24-17. Coming up, the State Farm postgame report with Mike Hall. So for Matt Millen, Lisa Byington, and Mike Pereira, I'm Kevin Kugler saying good night from Lincoln, Nebraska. The Huskers get the 7-point win over the Golden Gophers.